हेलो एवरीवन, इस पूरी सीरीज के अंदर हम पूरे सिलेबस को कवर करेंगे ऑन डिजिटल लॉजिक। और डिजिटल लॉजिक के अंदर जितने भी सिलेबस है, पूरा जो स्टार्टिंग से एंड तक हम पूरा टॉपिक जो है सब कवर करेंगे, और उसके साथ साथ हम कुछ प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस को भी यहाँ पर कवर करेंगे। तो आई होप जो क्लासेस है आपके लिए काफ़ी बेनिफिशियल रहेगा। तो आई थिंक यू नो माई नेम, माई नेम इज़ हिमांशु कौशिक, और मुझे गेट की फील्ड में स्टूडेंट्स को पढ़ाते हुए बहुत टाइम हो चुका है। मैं इंडिया के बेस्ट इंस्टीट्यूशंस के साथ ऑलरेडी काम कर चुका हूँ, और सब पहली बार मैंने गेट एग्ज़ाम क्लियर किया था, दैट वॉज इन 2011-12। तो ऑब्वियसली आप देख सकते हो कि इसी फील्ड में मुझे लगभग 10 साल से ज़्यादा एक्सपीरियंस हो चुका है। तो ऑब्वियसली हमारा जो एक्सपीरियंस है आपके लिए काफ़ी बेनिफिशियल रहेगा, तो इसी वजह से आप जो हमारी क्लासेस है उसको ज्वाइन कर सकते हैं। और अगर आप मेरा कोई भी कोर्स लेना चाहते हैं ऑन अन अकेडमी, तो अन अकेडमी पे मेरे पास दो तरह के कोर्सेज जो होते हैं। पहला जो है दैट इज़ कॉल्ड प्लस कोर्स, एंड सेकेंड इज़ आइकॉनिक कोर्स। तो प्लस कोर्स में स्पेशल ये है कि यहाँ पर इंडिया के बेस्ट टीचर्स यहाँ पर होते हैं, और साथ साथ में जो मेरी क्लासेस होती है काफ़ी इंट्रैक्टिव होती है, यानी कि आप और मैं क्लासेस के बीच में इंट्रैक्टिव या डिस्कशन हम लोग कर सकते हैं। और साथ साथ में जब आप आइकॉनिक कोर्स में जाएंगे तो आइकॉनिक में स्पेशल है, स्पेशल ये है कि एक मेंटर आपके साथ हमेशा साथ रहेगा। तो मेंटर, जब भी आपको कोई भी डाउट रहेगा, आपको कोई भी नोट्स की ज़रूरत होगी या फिर आपको कोई मोटिवेशन की ज़रूरत होगी, तो मेंटर हमेशा आपको सपोर्ट करेगा इन एनी वे। तो अगर मेरा कोई भी कोर्स लेना चाहते हैं विद अन अकेडमी, चाहे आप प्लस ले या फिर आइकॉनिक ले, मेरा कोई भी कोर्स अगर आप लेना चाहते हैं, जस्ट यूज़ अ कूपन कोड विच इज़ कौशिक 10, क्योंकि कौशिक 10 में आपको टोटल 10% ऑफ हमको मिल जाएगा। जस्ट यूज दिस एंड होप यू लाइक दिस। पूरी सीरीज जो है आपको बहुत अच्छी लगेगी, एंड थैंक यू सो मच। हेलो एवरीवन, इन दिस वीडियो लेट अस लुक एट व्हाट आर प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स, व्हाट आर असेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स, व्हाट आर सिलेक्टिव प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स एंड व्हाट आर रिडंडेंट प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू अ ब्रीफ आइडिया रिगार्डिंग ऑल ऑफ दीज इम्प्लिकेंट्स। मैंने आपको एक ब्रीफ आइडिया दिया था। इन दिस वीडियो लेट्स स्टडी अबाउट दीज थिंग्स इन मोर डिटेल्स। इन सभी चीज़ों को हम और ज़्यादा डिटेल्स के अंदर स्टडी करेंगे। नाउ इन दिस डायग्राम यू कैन सी दैट देर आर 3 प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स, बट लेट अस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एनालाइज व्हाट आर द नंबर ऑफ इम्प्लिकेंट्स एंड आउट ऑफ ऑल दोज इम्प्लिकेंट्स व्हाट आर द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स। ओके, सो एनी सब क्यूब हियर इज अ इम्प्लिकेंट। सो वी कैन हैव अ सब क्यूब ऑफ साइज 1, we can have a subcube of size 2, we can have a subcube of size 4, we can have a subcube of size 8, we can have a subcube of size 16, and so on. I mean in the powers of 2. Now in this case, this is subcube of size 1, it is an implicant. This is subcube of size 1, it is an implicant. Subcube of size 1, subcube of size 1, these all are representing implicants, and these all are your trivial implicants. ये जो इम्प्लिकेंट्स हैं ये हमेशा ट्रिवियल होंगे। नाउ दिस इज ऑल्सो एन इम्प्लिकेंट, राइट? सो दिस इज द 5th वन, दिस इज ऑल्सो एन इम्प्लिकेंट 6th वन, दिस इज ऑल्सो एन इम्प्लिकेंट 7th। सो यू कैन सी देर आर टोटल ऑफ 7 इम्प्लिकेंट्स इन दिस एग्जाम्पल। आउट ऑफ दीज 7 इम्प्लिकेंट्स देर आर ओनली 3 इम्प्लिकेंट्स विच आर कॉल्ड एज प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट। इन सभी 7 में से हमारे पास 3 ऐसे इम्प्लिकेंट है जिसको हम प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट बोलेंगे, ठीक है? सो दैट मीन्स सो आई टोल्ड यू व्हाट इज अ प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट। सो एनी इम्प्लिकेंट विच इज नॉट कंप्लीटली इनसाइड एनी अदर इम्प्लिकेंट, जैसे इफ आई से दिस इज वन इम्प्लिकेंट एंड दिस इज अनदर इम्प्लिकेंट, सो दिस इम्प्लिकेंट इज कंप्लीटली इनसाइड दिस इम्प्लिकेंट, देयरफॉर आई कैन से दिस बिगर वन इज योर प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट। सो इफ समथिंग लाइक दिस हैपन दैट दिस इज एन इम्प्लिकेंट एंड दिस इज अनदर इम्प्लिकेंट, राइट? सो दिस इज ऑल्सो ए प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट एंड देन दिस इज ऑल्सो ए प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट। बट इफ आई हैव इम्प्लिकेंट हियर इट इज नॉट अ प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट, इफ आई हैव इम्प्लिकेंट हियर इट इज नॉट अ प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट, इफ आई हैव इम्प्लिकेंट हियर इट इज नॉट अ प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट। सो आई मीन एनी सब क्यूब विच इज नॉट कम्प्लीटली अ पार्ट ऑफ एनी अदर सब क्यूब, जैसे यहाँ पर ये जो बड़े वाला सब क्यूब है इट इज नॉट कमिंग इन साइड एनी अदर सब क्यूब, राइट? सो इट इज अ prime implicant. So in the same way, if you look at this example, now in this example, this is a subcube which is not completely coming inside any other subcube. So this subcube is representing your prime implicant. This subcube which is not completely a part of any other subcube, therefore it is a prime implicant. As well as this subcube is also completely not a part of any other subcube, it is a prime implicant. So now let us look at what is a essential prime. यानी कि जितने भी आपके प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट हैं, If there is any prime implicant which is at least covering one term that is not covered by others, that is called as your prime implicant, right? So here, this is a prime implicant. This is a prime implicant, as well as this is also a prime implicant. But out of these three prime implicants, only this implicant as well as this implicant, they are called as essential prime. सिर्फ दो ही हमारे पास ऐसे implicant हैं यहाँ पर, जिसको हम essential prime बोलेंगे. Why are we going to call them as essential prime? Because at least they are covering one term that is not covered by others. Because ये वाला जो prime implicant है, ये किसी भी ऐसे term को cover नहीं कर रहा जो इसको कोई और cover ना करो. It is covering two terms, but both of these two terms are covered by others. राइट तो ये इसी वजह से ये जो आपका एक प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट है इट इज नॉट अ एसेंशियल प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट. ओके सो यू कैन रीड द डेफिनेशन आल्सो. सो दीज आर दोज सब क्यूब्स विच कवर एटलीस्ट वन मिन टर्म दैट कैन नॉट बी कवर्ड बाय एनी अदर प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट. एसेंशियल प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट्स आर दोज प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट्स विच ऑलवेज अपियर इन द फाइनल सॉल्यूशन. दे विल ऑलवेज बी इन द फाइनल सॉल्यूशन. द मिनिमल एक्सप्रेशन विल ऑलवेज कंटेन एसेंशियल प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट्स. And then you have redundant prime implicants. So those essential prime implicants, those prime implicants which are not essential, they are called as redundant. For example, here in this example, you can see that this is your essential prime implicant. This is also representing your essential prime implicant, but this one is not your essential one. This is redundant prime implicant. Isko hum bolenge redundant. Okay. Then we have selective prime implicant. Selective prime implicants, can I just read the definition once? The prime implicants for which are neither essential nor redundant prime implicants are called as selective prime. These are also known as non-essential prime implicant. They may appear in some solution and may not appear in some solutions. Yani ki aise prime implicants जो कि ना तो essential है और ना ही redundant है. They are neither essential nor redundant. Then we call such prime implicants as selective prime implicants. I'll show you with the help of examples. I'll cover more examples here where you will learn what is a selective prime implicant. So in this example here, we have let me just come back here. So here you can see this is representing an essential prime implicant because it is covering one term that is not covered by others. This is representing one term that is not covered by others. Therefore, this one and this one, both of them are essential. ये वाला और ये वाला, ये दोनों essential हैं. लेकिन अब ये वाली term तो किसी ने cover नहीं करी, right? This term is not covered by anyone else, right? लेकिन इस term को cover करने के लिए हमारे पास दो option हैं. या तो हम इस term को इस वाले prime implicant से cover कर लें, या फिर इस term को हम इस वाले prime implicant से cover करें. In our solution, obviously this term should be there, but we have two choices. To cover this term. So this is also a prime implicant, this is also a prime implicant. और हमारे पास दो choices हैं. तो ना तो ये जो prime implicant है ये essential है, because ये कुछ ऐसा cover नहीं कर रहा जिसको कोई और cover नहीं कर रहे. It is not covering any term which is not covered by others, right? As well as it is not covering any term which is not covered by others. तो obviously ये जो दोनों हैं, ये आपके पास essential नहीं हैं. But at the same time they are not redundant, because इन दोनों में से अगर आप किसी एक को ऐड नहीं करोगे देन योर सॉल्यूशन विल नॉट बी कंप्लीट. देन यू विल मिस आउट दिस टर्म. आप इस टर्म को मिस करेंगे. सो बेसिकली इन योर सॉल्यूशन आउट ऑफ दीज टू एट ओनली वन शुड बी देयर. या तो आप अपने सॉल्यूशन में इस वाले को कंसिडर करेंगे, या फिर आप अपने सॉल्यूशन में इस वाले प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट को कंसिडर करेंगे. ओके आई विल शो यू विद सम एग्जांपल्स. वंस यू विल आई विल टेक अ फ्यू एग्जांपल देन यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. ओके नाउ लेट अस लुक एट दिस एग्जांपल हियर. So I've already taken this example before. एक example हम लोग पहले भी देख चुके हैं. Now in this example you can see that we have four essential prime implicants. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. All of these four are representing essential prime implicant. And this subcube, it is just a prime implicant, but it is not essential. ये वाला जो सबक्यूब है, बड़े वाला जो सबसे बड़ा सबक्यूब यहाँ पर पॉसिबल है, इट इज जस्ट अ प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट बट इट इज नॉट असेंशियल. सो दिस प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट शुड नॉट कम इन द सॉल्यूशन, बिकॉज इफ यू विल ऐड दिस प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट देन योर सॉल्यूशन विल नॉट बी मिनिमाइज्ड. ठीक है, अब देखो इसको ऐड करने का मतलब क्यों नहीं होता. व्हाई वी आर नॉट इवन एडिंग दिस. वी आर नॉट इवन एडिंग दिस बिकॉज इट इज नॉट कवरिंग एनीथिंग दैट इज नॉट कवर्ड बाय अदर्स. इसके पास जितनी भी चीजें हैं वो सभी दूसरे प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट्स कवर कर रहे हैं. इट इज नॉट कवरिंग एनी स्पेशल मिनटम. करेक्ट. सो दिस देर इज नो पॉइंट ऑफ एडिंग दिस वन. इसको हमें ऐड करने की कोई भी जरूरत नहीं है. सो इन योर सॉल्यूशन दिस शुड नॉट कम. सो ओनली 4 मिनटर्म्स विल बी देयर इन द सॉल्यूशंस. वी विल नॉट बी हैविंग 5 मिनटर्म्स. ओके, नाउ कंसीडर दिस वन ऑल्सो. अब यहां पर क्या है, देखो दिस इज अ प्राइम एप्लीकेंट. क्लियर? दिस इज ऑल्सो ए प्राइम एप्लीकेंट. दिस इज ऑल्सो ए प्राइम एप्लीकेंट. This is also a prime implicant. This is also a prime implicant, as well as this is also a prime implicant. So here you can see there are a lot of prime implicants, but we do not have an essential prime implicant. यहाँ पर बहुत सारे prime implicant है, लेकिन यहाँ पर कोई भी essential prime implicant नहीं है. Why we are not having any essential prime implicant? Because every term is covered by 2 implicants. हर एक जो term है, जैसे for example this is a term. So every term is covered by 2 prime implicants. हर एक टर्म जो है 2 प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट उसको कवर कर रहा है. ठीक है? नाउ वी कैन से दैट देयर आर नो एसेंशियल प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट हियर. यहां पर कोई भी एसेंशियल प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट नहीं है, राइट? एंड देयर आर नो रिडंडेंट प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट्स आल्सो. यहां पर कोई रिडंडेंट प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट भी नहीं है. वी डू नॉट हैव अ रिडंडेंट प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट, एज वेल एज वी आल्सो डू नॉट हैव an essential prime implicant. Now to hamare paas redundant hai aur na hi essential hai. If you do not have a redundant and if you do not have an essential, please try to answer what kind of prime implicant we have. Hamare paas kis tarah ka implicant hai, what kind of implicant we have? We have selective prime implicant. Yahan par hamare paas selective prime implicant hai. Now what can I say, how can I say it is selective? Hum isko selective kyun bol sakte hain? Dekho, why we call it as a selective? If we select this prime implicant, if we select this prime implicant, then I do not have to select this one. Then I can select this one, because ye jo term hai wo hum already isko cover kar chuke hain. So if we select this one, then I can select this one, and then I can select this one. So basically we can have only 3 minterms. Hamare paas yahan par jo hamara solution hoga uske andar 3 minterms hi hongi. We only need 3 minterms here. We can have this as a solution. Ye hamare paas solution mein ho sakta hai. Or what I can do is, I can select this subcube. मैं subcube को सेलेक्ट कर सकता हूँ. I can select this subcube and I can select this subcube. So basically, just by using 3 minterms, I will be able to get the solution. So basically, whenever I say that we have a selective prime implicant, it means that prime implicant is neither essential, ना तो वो essential है, and at the same time, it is nor redundant. ना तो वो essential है और ना ही वो redundant है. Then we call it as a selective prime implicant. So in this case we have a selective prime implicant. There are 6 selective prime implicants, there are 6 prime implicants, there are 0 essential prime implicant, there are 0 redundant prime implicant. Theek hai? So for this given problem there are 2 different solutions are available. Yahan par 2 alag alag solutions available hai. Now this kind of problem can also be solved by using prime implicant chart. इस तरह का जो प्रॉब्लम है, समटाइम्स इट इज वेरी कॉमन दैट यू गाइस और पीपल मेक मिस्टेक इन दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स. देयरफॉर वी नीड समथिंग कॉल्ड एज प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट चार्ट. सो आई विल एक्सप्लेन, आई विल कवर व्हाट इज अ प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट चार्ट. लॉट ऑफ वीडियोज विल बी कमिंग, तो मैं प्राइम इंप्लीकेंट चार्ट को काफी अच्छे से कवर करूंगा. यू विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से. सो लेट अस लुक एट दिस एग्जांपल हियर. अगेन इन दिस एग्जांपल यू कैन सी there are no essential prime implicant. इस example में कोई भी essential prime implicant नहीं है. There are no essential prime implicant, there are no redundant prime implicant. All the implicants that we have, all of these implicants are selective prime implicant. जितने भी prime implicant है ये selective है. So number of implicants here, कितने implicants हैं यहाँ पर? I think yes, there are 2 essential prime implicant. Because I think I've not seen the figure. मैंने figure को नहीं देखा था, so I made the decision without even seeing the figure. If we have something like this, अगर यहाँ पर आपके पास एक 1 होता, if you have a 1 here, then you could have seen कि यहाँ पर कोई भी essential prime implicant नहीं है. So because we do not have a 1 here, that is why we do not, this is not an essential prime implicant. Okay? Now anyways, so here we have 2 essential prime implicant, we have 4 selective prime implicant. So any of your solution, in any of your solution, both of these essential prime implicants should be there. जो भी आप solution propose करेंगे, in any solution that you propose, essential prime implicant should always be there. आप कुछ भी solution propose करेंगे, वहाँ पर essential prime implicant होंगे ही होंगे. Now in this case, you can see 1 and 4, both are essential prime implicant. So here in both the solutions, 1 and 4 are there. But for all the selective prime applicant, we have choices. Either this can be there or this will not be there. If this is there, then I do not need this one. So, मुझे इसकी ज़रूरत नहीं है. Then I can only cover this one, right? So for all the selective prime applicants, we have choices. And according to the choices, you can identify how many unique solutions are possible. या तो वहाँ पर 2 होगा, या फिर वहाँ पर 5 होगा, या तो वहाँ पर 3 होगा, या फिर वहाँ पर 6 होगा. So we have choices. Okay? I will also explain you with the help of our prime applicant chart. जो हमारा prime applicant chart है, मैं उसको साथ एक question को आपको explain करूँगा. Don't worry. Okay? तो let me do one thing. Maybe I can also try and explain this previous example. I'll do the next video. In this next video, I'll try to explain this one using a prime applicant chart. Then you will understand why we do not need this as a solution. Okay, so let me pause the video right here and I'll make the next video. Previous video mein maine aapko bataya tha, I told you in the previous video that what are prime implicants, essential prime implicants, selective prime implicants and redundant prime implicants. And in that previous video, I have also shown you a K-map like this. And in that K-map, I told you that we do not have any essential prime implicant. आपके पास कोई भी essential prime implicant नहीं है. You do not have any essential prime implicant, but rather all the implicants that are present in that diagram, all of those implicants are selective prime implicants. Okay? So here in this example, let us look at it in more details. Okay? Now in this case, we are going to have so many subcubes. Let me also mark out all the subcubes with you. So this is one of the subcube, correct? This is another subcube. This is another subcube. As well as we can also have this as a subcube. आपके पास ये भी एक subcube हो सकता है. But apart of this, you also have other subcubes. इसके अलावा और भी subcubes आपके पास possible है. You can combine this one with this one. You can combine this one with this one. आप इन दोनों को combine कर सकते हैं. You can combine these two. So you can clearly see that in this diagram, we do not have any essential prime implicant. Now, sometimes to solve this kind of questions, it becomes very tricky how to solve it. But there's one method which is very trustable method, and using that method, you can easily solve such kind of problems. And that method is called as prime implicant chart. In this video, I'm going to tell you about what is a prime implicant chart. So the topic that we have here is prime implicant chart. Okay, so basically we are trying to identify what are the implicants that I can use in my solution. So to do that, first of all, I have to mention all of these numbers, or I can say all of these subcube. I have to make a table here. So I'm going to make the table in this manner. This is the table. So here we have total of 16 values. So we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So basically the maximum value here is 15 only, because we have 0 to 15. So we do not have 16. Okay. And now, let us try to analyze what each of these subcubes is representing. ये हर एक subcube क्या क्या represent कर रहा है, and how many subcubes do we have? So this is representing A complement, B complement, A complement B, AB and AB complement. This one is C complement, D complement, C complement D, CD and CD complement. Okay. So we will take this horizontal subcube. We'll start with this horizontal subcube. What this horizontal subcube is presenting? It is representing A complement, B complement and C complement. Ye kya represent kar raha hai? A complement, B complement and C complement. Then what this horizontal subcube is representing? It is representing A complement, B and D. This horizontal subcube is representing A, B and C. And this horizontal subcube here, it is representing A, B complement and D complement. Okay, so I've taken 4 of them now. Now let us find out the other 4. जो दूसरे 4 हैं आपके पास यहाँ पर, let us try to analyze them also. ठीक है? So this is the green one. So I think I do not have a space there. Let me write it here. So this is the green one. So this green one is representing C complement, D complement and B complement. Okay. So this green one here, it is representing C complement, D and A complement. This green one here, it is representing C, D and B. And this green one here, ye jo green wala hai, this one is representing C, D complement and we have A. Okay, so you have to make all of these values properly, right? Because there are many times we do a lot of mistakes here. Ye jo diagram hai, thoda sa confusing hai. So sometimes while solving such kind of questions, we make mistakes. So obviously I'm not such exception. Maybe I've also made a mistake, but we will try to analyze all of the, if I've done any mistake, I'll try to analyze. So let's first try to understand what the concept says. So here I try to identify what are all the implicates. So sabhi implicates kya hai? Now I'm going to write all of these implicates here. So let us take each of these implicates one by one. So we have the implicates, which is A complement, B complement, C complement. We have A complement, B and D. We have A, B and C. We have A, B complement and D complement. We have A complement, D and C complementation. And then we have C, D and B, or you can say B, C, D. You can say it as a B, C and D. Then we have A, C and D complementation. And then we have B complement, C complement and D complement. So I've written all of them like this. Okay. And now I'm going to just put some lines here so that it will be easier for me to understand. Taki mujhe thoda sa samajhna aasan ho jaye. For that reason, I'm going to divide this into tables, or you can say rows and columns like this, so that it will become very easy for me to fill this table. Is table ko bharna mere liye aasan ho jaye, is wajah se maine itko is tarike se divide kar liya hai. Okay. Now let us look at each one of them. So first one is A complement, B complement, C complement. So this A complement, B complement, C complement is covering the term 0 and 1. So wherever we have 0 and 1, I'm going to put a cross mark here. I'm going to put a cross mark here as well as a cross mark here. Then I will take the next one. So jo agla aapke paas hai, this is B, C, D. Okay, I think A complement BD. So we have A complement DD, BD. So this A complement BD is covering 5 and 7. So wherever I have 5 and 7, I'm going to put a cross mark over there. Then we have ABC. So this ABC is covering 5, 15 and 14. So ABC is covering 15 and 14. So I'm going to put a cross mark. Okay. Then we have A, B complement and D complement. And this A, B complement, D complement, it is covering the term 8 and 10. So ye jo hai, 8 ko aur 10 ko cover kar raha hai. Then we have A, B complement, D complement. So this is the term which is, I think, where is this term? Let me check again. We have A, B complement and D complement. I think this is the A, B complement and D complement, I think. So I've already covered it. So ABC, yeah, so I think I've made a mistake here. So yahan par main thoda sa mistake kiya hai. This A complement, B complement, D complement is covering 8 and 10. So this is here. So 8 or 10 jo hai, wo kuch yahan par hai. 8 is here as well as 10 is here. Next one is A complement, D, C complement, right? A complement, D, C complement, and it is covering C complement, D. Theek hai, to ye kya cover kar raha hai? This is 1 and 5. To ye cover kar raha hai hamare paas 1 ko aur 5 ko. Uske baad we have B, C, D. So, jo aapke paas B, C, D hai, where is B, C, D? So, we have, let me look at. So, this is B, C, D. So, this B, C, D is covering the term 7 and 15. So, jo B, C, D hai, wo 7 ko aur 15 ko cover kar raha hai. It is covering 7 and 15. Then, we have A, C, D complement. So, this A, C, D complement is covering the term 14 and 10. So ACD complement is covering 14 as well as it is also covering the term 10. And then the last one here, which is B complement, C complement, D complement, it is covering 0 and 8. It is covering 0 as well as it is covering 8. Okay. So this chart is called as your prime implicant chart. Is chart ko hum bolte hain prime implicant chart. I think some of the portion is not visible. Let me try if I can make it visible. Main aapko thoda sa koshish karta hun. Just give me a second. So I believe this chart is now visible. Let us look at each of these one. Dekho, basically what I'm trying to say is, my aim is, I want to cover all the terms here. Jo jahan par hamare paas one hai, I want to cover all of these ones. Mujhe in sabhi one ko cover karna hai. That means in my solution equation, I have to identify which one should I add. So jaise here, if I add this in my solution equation, agar apne solution equation mein A complement, B complement aur C complement ko add karta hun, if I add this in my solution equation, then I will cover the term 0 as well as I will cover the term 1. Main 0 aur 1 ko cover kar lunga. Okay, now if I add the term A complement BD, agar main A complement BD ko apne solution mein add karta hun, if I add A complement BD, then I will be able to cover the term 5 as well as I will be able to cover the term 7. Main 5 or 7 ko cover kar lunga. Okay, and then if I add this term, which is A, B complement, D complement in my solution, that is A, B complement and D complement in my solution, then using this term, I will be able to cover 8 as well as I will be able to cover 9. Main yahan se 8 or 9 ko bhi cover kar lunga. And then if I add this one, which is ABC in my solution, agar main ABC ko apne solution mein add karta hun, then I will be able to cover 14 and 15, right? So that means in my solution, I need only 4 min terms, and with the help of all of these 4 min terms, I have covered every term in this K map. Sirf in 4 min terms ke help se, maine is K map ke andar sabhi terms ko cover kar liya hai. I've covered every term in this K map. So because I've covered every term here, I do not really have to add any of this. Mujhe inko kisi mein se kisi ko bhi add karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Why I do not have to add them? Because they are not covering any term which is not covered by them. Inhone hi sab kuch ko cover kar liya, so we do not have to add them. Okay? In the same way, you can choose, if I do not use this term, agar main is term ko use nahi karta, then I might be having a choice for the other term. Mere paas dusri term ko use karne ke liye bhi koi choice ho sakti hai. So for such kind of questions, more than one solution equations are possible. Is tarah ke questions mein ek se zyada solution equations jo hain wo possible hain. Okay, so for such kind of questions, you can also try and make prime implicant chart. Ab yahan par prime implicant chart ko bhi use kar sakte hain. Now after all the things that we have covered so far, come back to my first slide, come back to my beginning slide. So in the beginning slide, I told you what is a K-map. So in your K-map, you are representing all the min terms. So jitne bhi min terms hain, we represent all of these min terms with the help of 1, and we represent all the max terms with the help of 0. So jitne bhi aapki min term hain, unko hum 1 se represent karte hain, and jitne bhi aapki max terms hain, unko hum 0 se represent karte hain. So the same concept which is valid on min terms, similar concept is also valid on max term, but the only difference here is, in case of max term, wherever we have 0, 0, we do not write them in a complemented form, but rather we write them in an uncomplemented form. I will take that in example. I will take a few examples where I will also try to find the max terms, and I will also try to find some of the min terms. Okay. So I told you that you can skip this PPT. Now look at this PPT. Ye PPT kya represent kar rahi hai? So this PPT is representing that if we have a K-map like this, and if you fold this K-map in a, you know, let me show you with the help of an example. Okay, so let us assume this is your K-map. Ye aapka K-map hai. So what I can do is, I can fold this K-map in the form of a circle like this. Main iski map ko is tarike se circle mein fold kar sakta hun, and then I can combine all the end of the circle here in the K-map. So har ek jo circle ka jo sabhi end hai, main usko kuch is tarike se combine kar sakta hun. Okay, then I mean to say, in this manner I can do, I have a K-map, I can fold this K-map in the form of cylinder, and then I can combine the ends of the K-map in this manner, and then this K-map will look something like this. So it is looking like a donut. Kis tarah se dikh raha hai ye? Ye ek donut ki tarah se dikh raha hai. Right? So when you do it something like this, then all of your corners, ye jitne bhi aapke corner hai, all of your corners will come together, and when these corners will come together, if the values of these corners, jaise yahan par, if the value of this corner is 1, let me just write it down here. So if the value of this corner is 1, here we have a 1, here we have a 1, as well as here also we have a 1, then we can combine all of these ones together, because they will make a subcube like this. Wo yahan par is tarike se ek subcube ko form karega, it will make a subcube like this. That is why I can combine ऑल ऑफ दीज फोर कॉर्नर्स। इसी वजह से मैं गेम मैप में इन सभी कॉर्नर्स को भी कंबाइन कर सकता हूँ। ओके, आई होप दैट यू अंडरस्टूड दिस पार्ट। लेट अस लुक एट द नेक्स्ट वीडियो। इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व द के मैप्स फॉर द मैक्स टर्म्स।